Small in size, big in ambitions. Djibouti may be one of the tiniest, youngest, and least known nations in Africa, but it could also well be the most talented, or depending on your perspective, the most opportunistic. While its larger, more powerful neighbours are embroiled in a never-ending border dispute, Djibouti stands out as a haven of stability and neutrality. The geographical position of the country, sandwiched between three stronger nations, and its strategic value as a port, is as important as ever. Djibouti's location is the main economic asset of a country that is mostly barren. The capital, Djibouti City, handles Ethiopian imports and exports. Its transport facilities are used by several landlocked African countries to fly in their goods for re-export. Roughly half of the people are Issas and related Somali clans. Afars are about one-third, and the balance includes Yemeni, Arabs and Europeans, mostly French. Djibouti has a developing market economy that is based almost entirely on trade and commercial services, centering on Djibouti City. The country is a multi-party republic with one legislative house. Its head of state and government is the president. Djibouti also hosts the EU and NATO naval missions responsible for counter-piracy off the Horn of Africa. And this year, they also hosted the 6th annual ALDEPAC conference. ALDEPAC is the Alliance of Liberals and Democrats for Europe, the Pacific, Africa and the Caribbean, and was set up to promote dialogue and partnerships between the European and ACP members of the Liberal Democratic Network.
Sur le plan de la piraterie, nous sommes consternés par l'ampleur des attaques. Ce fléau, que l'on croyait tous appartenir au passé, cause chaque jour des drames et a des conséquences néfastes autant pour les personnes que pour les États.
The discussions by delegates, including the President of Djibouti, ALDEPAC leader Guelleh Verhofstadt, MEPs from the European Parliament, and MPs from over 25 African countries, were dominated by the regional security challenges, in particular Somalia, and their wider impact in Africa.
Djibouti, d'abord, est un endroit qui assure une certaine stabilité. C'est un endroit stratégique. Et comme Djibouti est plutôt une démocratie, ben, il est évident qu'elle a un rôle stabilisateur. Il y a actuellement un gros problème entre Djibouti et l'Érythrée. Et on essaie de travailler là-dessus. Donc j'espère que ce problème-là sera abouti. Ceci dit, la Corne de l'Afrique, c'est évidemment une région à haut risque. Tous les détonateurs d'une explosion sont évidemment présents ici. C'est la raison pour laquelle, à la Commission européenne, on avance avec une stratégie globale. Le principe de la stratégie globale, c'est de dire mettons tous ces pays ensemble pour qu'ils affrontent ensemble les défis qu'ils ont en commun. La sécheresse, la famine et la crise alimentaire, les problèmes de l'eau, l'eau du Nil, le pastoralisme, le nomadisme, tout ça sont des questions que chaque pays doit résoudre. Et donc, mettons-les ensemble pour qu'ils s'occupent plutôt d'économie plutôt que de se disputer ou plutôt que de faire des dissensions politiques.
Nicolo Rinaldi, co-chair of ALDEPAC, explains what was achieved over the three-day conference.
Well, first of all, what has been achieved in those 3 days in Djibouti is a great sense of being a family among ourselves with the ALDEPAC colleagues. This is the 6th annual conference, so it is a project which is lasting more and more solid. We had the courage to tackle an extremely difficult issue such as the Horn of Africa, which is probably the heart of darkness now in Africa, a region plenty of desperation, of suffering, of pain for the population, and indeed a diplomatic political nightmare, because perspective for sorting out Somalia of its crisis are extremely difficult, are extremely uncertain, and other countries such as Eritrea, they play a very difficult role in the region, while we have still a situation of instability, although with some good hope now for Sudan, and particularly for southern of Sudan.
The peaceful creation of the new nation in southern Sudan was welcomed, and support expressed for the democratic forces in Somaliland. During the opening ceremony, Guy Verhofstadt sent a clear message to African leaders. Democracy never guarantees permanent power. Democracy gives citizens the power to change.
La communauté internationale avait peur du référendum au Soudan du Sud. Une peur sans fondation. parce que le taux de participation était énorme. Des dizaines de milliers de gens ont fait une route de parfois deux jours à pied pour pouvoir faire entendre leur voix. Un événement tout à fait remarquable. Et plus que 90% a voté en faveur de l'indépendance. Et les résultats, c'est que le 9 juillet, la naissance du 54e État de l'Union africaine pourrait être proclamée. Eh bien, c'est à nous, l'Union européenne, de soutenir le processus et les négociations avec le Soudan maintenant pour qu'on puisse atteindre plus de stabilité dans la région et aussi plus de coopération avec la région. Et c'est pour cela que personnellement, Monsieur le Président, je vais plaider au sein de l'Union qu'on ouvre une ambassade européenne à Djouba et que le Sud-Soudan puisse devenir membre de l'ACP pour que le Sud-Soudan ait avec l'Union européenne une relation privilégiée.
Notre volonté de promouvoir la paix dans cette région tourmentée qui est la corne de l'Afrique ne date pas d'hier. Le principal objectif de cette politique pacifiste réside dans notre foi que nous ne pourrons pas jouir pleinement des fruits de la stabilité et de la sécurité dans notre pays tant que nos voisins continueront à souffrir des affres de la guerre et de l'instabilité. Vous n'êtes pas sans savoir la tragédie du peuple somalien, un drame qui dure depuis deux décennies.
Minister Moses Ndlovu, who is the Deputy Minister of Foreign Affairs in Zimbabwe, explains how important it is to unite members of parliament from Europe and Africa to brainstorm on such issues such as fighting terrorism and fighting piracy.
For me, it is important that you present parliamentarians with an opportunity to be on site. And so really being in Djibouti for us is saying you are on site. And it is a huge experience for one to have to deliberate on the issues under discussion here within range of the actual subject matter under discussion, the issues around peace and security. First of all, it is the message to the governments in the region on behalf of the peoples that they represent, that the rest of the world is behind them. And we are expecting governments around here to take it as a matter of urgency, to begin to initiate moves that will ensure that there's peace and security in this region, if ever we have to achieve development.
We asked delegates what role Djibouti plays in the military stability in the Horn of Africa.
I think it's a central role because it's in the middle of this region. It's not a big country, a small country. But strategically, it is the most important place, I think, in the region, in the Horn of Africa. And at the same time, it's a stable democracy and an example for the other countries. So what we are expecting from the president and the prime minister and this government is to push forward a strategy for the region. And maybe countries like Somalia, Ethiopia can accept that easier from Djibouti than from another country.
Nous sommes actuellement dans une situation très délicate où il y a une situation de guerre civile à une région très tourmentée. Donc, étant donné que le sujet que la ADLE-SPECIAL-EVENT a choisi cette année appelait donc que cette une réunion soit, ça se passe à Djibouti parce que nous sommes le mieux indiqué pour parler justement de ce thème.
La Corne d'Afrique, c'est un pays qui, c'est une région où il y a eu beaucoup de conflits, que ce soit le conflit de la Somalie, le conflit entre l'Éthiopie et l'Érythrée, récemment le conflit avec Djibouti et l'Érythrée, et sans parler des problèmes de ce qui s'est passé à Nairobi, sans parler des problèmes du Soudan. Tout ceci a fait que Djibouti a toujours joué un rôle positif pour l'avènement de la paix. Et aujourd'hui, le fait que nous recevons une conférence qui a pour thème la paix est quelque chose de très important pour nous.
Djibouti, c'est un pays stable dans la région. Et c'est très important de souligner ça parce que la stabilité de Djibouti permet aux forces coalisées internationales qui luttent contre la piraterie et auparavant contre le terrorisme d'opérer depuis Djibouti et d'avoir une base stable et solide comme base d'opération. Par ailleurs, Djibouti a suffisamment de liens et de relations privilégiées avec le peuple somalien pour en même temps comprendre leurs besoins et leurs problèmes et essayer d'être un peu leur avocat. Parce que vous savez que la question de la piraterie est liée essentiellement à la situation d'aujourd'hui de la Somalie. Et il est très important pour le peuple djiboutien d'être avec les frères somaliens dans cette lutte contre la piraterie.
Minister Margaret Kamara from Kenya, who is a former co-chair of ALDEPAC, explains how she feels the EU can contribute to conflict resolution in this region.
The EU has a lot to help in this. As you know, we are here as a group of members of the ACP EU Parliament. I was there myself until recently when I was appointed to be a minister in Kenya. It is very important that the EU takes a very strong role, being an old partner of Africa, and in particular knowing that the Horn was an area that was liberated at independence from European colonialism. There is a lot that links Africa to Europe, and especially this region to the European countries. It is very important that as we discuss the way forward for the Horn of Africa, the peace, the security and the development of the Horn of Africa, that the EU is fully involved, right from finding solutions for a stable government in Somalia, to the question of piracy, and more to the development. Because what we are saying is, if a country is developed, then there is no room to have a lot of people who are unemployed, or people who are feeling poverty-stricken, or people who are feeling unfairly treated. And this is how we can remove 50%, I must say, of the issues of piracy are coming because of social interventions that could be dealt with. And I think the EU should partner with the region in looking at the social interventions alone that can change the standards of living and the way people live in this region.
Dr. Tola, Programme Coordinator of Regional Conflict Prevention Management and Resolution, spoke during the working group session on fighting terrorism. He explained how such conferences can contribute to conflict resolution.
For example, if you see the Horn of Africa is the epic center historically, today and hopefully not in the future, there are conflicts both intrastate and interstate. So when we come here and exchange ideas with government officials, international organizations, regional organizations, and mostly the participation of the European Union, that will in the long run contribute to lessening the effects of war and conflict in the region.
This three-day conference was split into working sessions tackling issues such as the causes and conflicts in the Horn of Africa, fighting terrorism, fighting piracy more effectively, and humanitarian challenges in the Horn of Africa. Delegates also exchanged views with NGOs, and we asked one representative of a women's NGO in Djibouti what role they played in protecting women in this region.
Nous nous occupons essentiellement de sensibilisation. Donc nous sommes, on va dire que nous sommes de tous les combats, de la lutte contre la pauvreté, de la lutte contre toute forme de violence à l'égard des femmes, que ce soit les femmes battues, que ce soit les femmes excisées, que ce soit les femmes qui luttent pour avoir leur pension alimentaire après une séparation. Donc nous nous occupons, nous parlons de ça en théâtre.
On the last day of our conference, ALDEPAC adopted the Djibouti Declaration. Johan van Hekke is the co-founder of ALDEPAC, and he explains to us what this declaration is about.
What we are saying in the declaration is, first of all, we need to give more resources to AMISOM. AMISOM is the African Union peacekeeping force in Somalia. But there is no peace to keep. So we should consider to really review the mandate and give them much more power also to infiltrate outside Mogadishu in the country. And three, tackle the root causes of all these conflicts. And what is the root cause? Poverty, poverty, poverty. So once the conditions have been created, once there is a minimum of stability, there should go much more humanitarian aid to Somalia and to Somalia refugees. One of the speakers mentioned yesterday that in fact there's a lot of money coming from Arab countries available for the refugees from Palestine, but it's almost nothing for the refugees of Somalia. That is not normal. So in this order, dialogue, in order to find a solution, structural solution for the political problems. And secondly, do whatever we can to reinforce the mandate of AMISOM, the African Union peacekeeping force. And then once there is a minimum of stability, make sure that we tackle the root cause. And the root cause is called poverty.
ALDEPAC also elected a new honorary president, Mr. Diallo, a Guinean economist and politician who was Prime Minister of Guinea from 2004 to 2006. Currently, he is president of the Union of Democratic Forces of Guinea, an opposition party. He explains to us his vision for the future of ALDEPAC.
Nous avons la prochaine réunion annuelle, mais d'ici là, enfin, étant donné que je suis le président honoraire, il n'est pas exclu qu'on fasse des réunions du présidium pour essayer de voir quelles mesures conviendrait-il de prendre afin de dynamiser notre association pour qu'elle apporte plus justement dans la promotion des grandes valeurs qui fondent sa création.